Our lead story, well, the cabinet has approved the unified pension scheme. With this now, there will be an assured 50% of the salary as pension for government employees. Well, the government says that this will benefit over 23 lakh central government employees. This was a long-standing demand from various bureaucrat associations, and this has been welcomed by bureaucrats. Now, remember, the government also approved various other important decisions in the cabinet briefing, but the unified pension scheme has now been approved. What really does it mean for you? My colleague Sunil Prabhu decodes.
The cabinet today has decided to unveil a unified pension scheme which will be effective from 1st of April next year. This was a big bone of contention, especially among state governments, amongst employees who felt that they had lost out. It became a political issue. The cabinet today, after extensive consultations with varied people across the country, has now finally unveiled what is now going to be called the unified pension scheme, which ensures and assures people across the country, those who are working in government service, after 25 years, that they will get 50% of their basic salary, which was last drawn for the last 12 months. Having said that, various other provisions in terms of indexation has taken place. It will continue to be contributory, and as has been pointed out, 99% of the people will shift from the new pension scheme to the unified pension scheme because it is more beneficial and it will continue to be contributory. The initial first year, there will be an excess of around 800 crores which will be cost to the exchequer. And overall, as they say, this will be beneficial to government employees, and even those who have a shorter tenure will be able to get an assured minimum guarantee. Apart from family pensions, for those who are entitled to, they too will be able to benefit in terms of a minimum return that is assured in terms of indexation that will take place.
And well, the government says that there will be an option between NPS and UPS. But looking at some other news now, the Home Minister has made a big remark in Raipur. He says Naxalism will be wiped out completely by 2026. He also says that 2024 has been the most successful year in terms of anti-Naxal operations. Listen in.
मुझे विश्वास है कि हमारी लड़ाई अंतिम चरण में पहुंची है और हम देश को 2026 मार्च तक पूर्णतया नक्सल समस्या से मुक्त कर पाएंगे। अब तक के वामपंथी उग्रवादी विचारधारा के खिलाफ लड़ाई में सबसे अच्छा प्रदर्शन अगस्त महीना होने के बावजूद भी इस वर्ष में हम कर पाए हैं।
And moving now to our big focus on NDTV, well, the RG Kar hospital horror, in which now the CBI, which is looking at the investigation, has registered a corruption case against the ex-principal of the medical college. Well, the CBI has filed a financial irregularities case against the ex-principal Sanjay Ghosh, who has been appearing before the central agency for days on end. Now, remember, there are charges of corruption, lapses and also irregularities. There are even charges of human trafficking that took place allegedly inside the hospital when he was at the helm. So the CBI will now be probing corruption allegations as well. And in other news now, the horrific rape of a minor girl in Assam's Nagaon. And well, now the prime suspect, the accused, has died after he was arrested by the police. In fact, the police took him to recreate the crime scene in Nagaon, where he reportedly, and as per the police, jumped into this very pond where he allegedly brutalized the victim. And the police say that it's a case of suicide. Take a look at this report.
The body of the Assam rape accused being taken out of this pond, just next to the scene of crime at Dhing in Assam's Nagaon district.
This is the place where on Thursday evening, around 6:30 p.m. in the evening, there near the banana plants that you can see at a distance, passerbys actually saw a 14-year-old girl lying there almost unconscious with a cycle besides her. The girl was allegedly raped here by three suspects. And today, early in the morning, between 3 to 4 a.m., he was brought here to recreate the scene of crime, to reconstruct the scene, crime scene. And what police claims is that the suspect, that point of time, tried to flee. He tried to flee and he was handcuffed. Even then, he tried to flee, and in the process, he fell in this pond. And then police cordoned off this area, and later, after searching this pond, his body was found.
Then we came to the scene of crime to exactly know where the things have happened, because we couldn't ask the girl. She is in hospital. At that moment, she tried to forcefully evade police arrest and jumped into the pond.
The family of the accused are questioning the custodial death, but others in his village have dissociated themselves from him.
তফাজলৰ ঘৰক সামাজিকভাৱে আমি বহিষ্কাৰ কৰিছো গাঁৱৰ ৰাইজ অপৰাধীৰ পক্ষত নাই আমি সদায় ন্যায়ৰ পক্ষত আছো আৰু ন্যায়ৰ পক্ষত
Meanwhile, Assam Chief Minister Himanta Biswa Sarma has said that his police force have zero tolerance for crimes against women.
ये असम में कुछ घटना होने से पुलिस तुरंत जो भी एक्शन लेना है तुरंत लेते हैं तो हमारा कोई इसमें कॉम्प्रोमाइज नहीं We have a zero tolerance policy. So that is the difference.
From women to students to civil society groups in this small town of Dhing have been protesting ever since the minor girl was allegedly raped. They want the perpetrators to be arrested and justice delivered to the victim. And they say that this is not one-off case. They believe and they demand that from Kolkata to Dhing, there is a pattern, and they want that center now should bring a strong legislation.
This cannot be considered as a stray incident. Similar incidents have been going on in the state of Assam for several months now. The Chief Minister is saying that in last 2 months, 22 women have been exploited sexually in Assam. He should feel ashamed to give such statement. He is in charge of the Home Ministry. This is the plight in Assam. He has died in police custody. That is one part. But the local people are angst with the situation. And the primary concern is that when will other two culprits will be arrested and what punishment will they get?
মই এটাই কথাই কব বিচাৰো যাতে সমগ্ৰ মোৰ ছোৱালীজনী আজি যিটো ঘটনা হৈ গ'ল কাইলৈ বেলেগ ছোৱালীও হ'ব পাৰে সেইকাৰণে চৰকাৰে যাতে সমগ্ৰ নাৰীকে ৰক্ষণাবেক্ষণ দি ৰাখিব পাৰে সেইটোৱে মই চৰকাৰৰ ওচৰত অনুৰোধ জনাই
While pressure is mounting on cops to nab the other two suspects, women in Dhing have now launched an indefinite protest. With Nakul Rabha in Dhing and Ratandeep Chaudhary, Bureau Report, NDTV.
In other news now, the son of the former Chief Minister of Telangana, KTR, appeared before the Women's Commission and he tendered an unconditional apology for his earlier remarks. In fact, these are visuals of KTR being taken to the Women's Commission. In fact, there were protests as well outside the Women's Commission. In fact, there was some sort of a scuffle between BRS and Congress workers as well. KTR says that his remarks were not meant to hurt women. There was a lot of outrage over what many call distasteful remarks by KTR. And with that, we'll take a short break now, but news continues on the other side. Welcome back. Astronauts Sunitha Williams and Barry Butch-Wilmore in space for almost 80 days will return only on February next year. This is what NASA has said, but they will return with Crew 9. The Starliner will return uncrewed. Our science editor Pallav Bagla is now joining us live on the phone line. Mr. Bagla, what more details do you have?
Well, the details are very simple, that Indian origin astronaut Sunitha Williams, who she went on an 8-day mission to the International Station on a test flight of the Boeing Starliner, will now stay at the International Space Station for 8 months. So an 8-day mission converts to an 8-month mission at the International Space Station, and the Boeing Starliner will come back uncrewed. This is what the chief of NASA, Bill Nelson, has announced. And they said that this has been done to ensure for the safety of the crew. And he recalled that they've had 2 accidents of the space shuttle in the past, and they did not want to take a chance with that. So at the same time, astronaut Sunitha Williams is a veteran of space flights, and her stay at the International Space Station, NASA says, will be prolonged and will help in contributing to science and technology at the International Space Station. She and her crewmate, Butch Wilmore, will now return on a SpaceX Crew Dragon sometime in February 2025. So 8-day mission converts into an 8-month mission for Indian origin astronaut Sunita Williams.
All right, Mr. Bagla, thanks very much for joining us with the latest there. So very important there, NASA now saying that the Starliner will return uncrewed, and it's only by February next year that astronaut Sunita Williams is expected to return to Earth. And now our special report from Madhya Pradesh. Well, Anurag Dwari does a reality check on government hospitals in the state, how banned drugs are still being administered to patients. Take a look.
Have you ever wondered why you are not recovering despite taking your prescribed medicines? This question perplexed doctors at a government hospital in Indore. Their investigations revealed that the health of certain medicines in Madhya Pradesh is compromised.
मेरे जो डॉक्टर्स हैं जो कि इंटेंसिव केयर में काम करते हैं ओटी में काम करते हैं वो मुझे कंटिन्यूसली ये फीडबैक दे रहे थे कि सर एक इंजेक्शन से देने से जो असर आना चाहिए वो उतना आ नहीं रहा है हम लोगों को कई बार दो दो इंजेक्शन तीन तीन इंजेक्शन भी देने पड़ रहे हैं
In Damoh, the situation turned tragic when 5 pregnant women lost their lives after being administered intravenous saline. NETV has got a copy of a shocking report that exposed this life-threatening fraud. Large batches of 9 crucial drugs, including life-saving medications, antibiotics, and multivitamins, have been banned from use in any hospital across the state. The Madhya Pradesh Public Health Services Corporation Limited has issued letters to all district deans, CMHOs and hospital superintendents prohibiting the use of these drugs.
दवाइयाँ खरीदते समय उनके सर्टिफिकेट हम लोग चेक करते हैं दवाइयाँ जब आ जाती हैं उसके बाद में उनके सैंपल कलेक्ट करके उनको भी प्रयोगशालाओं में भेजते हैं उसी का परिणाम है कि जो जिन सप्लायरों ने या जिन फैक्ट्रीज ने ऐसी दवाई बनाई थी जो जनता पर असरकारक नहीं थी या जिनका उल्टा असर हो सकता था ऐसे उनको आइडेंटिफाई यदि हमारे डॉक्टर्स ने किया है हमारी लेबोरेटरीज ने किया तो निश्चित रूप से मैं समझता हूँ कि एक पारदर्शी व्यवस्था है अब सप्लायरों ने भी कोई गलत दवाई सप्लाई करने का प्रयास किया उनको प्रतिबंध भी लगाएंगे उनको ब्लैकलिस्ट भी करेंगे और उनके खिलाफ जो भी सख्त कानूनी कार्रवाई हो सकती है ऐसे लोगों के खिलाफ कानून के तहत सख्त कार्रवाई करेंगे
Government hospitals require an NABL certified lab certificate before medicines are supplied. MPPHSCL only purchase drugs after confirming their quality. The hospital storekeepers send these medicines to government labs for testing, followed by random inspections by Food and Drug Administration inspectors. But these procedures seem to be more on paper than in practice. NDTV went to a medicine shop in Bhopal's biggest government hospital, Hamidia, to uncover the ground reality of the availability of banned medicines. Despite the state's recent crackdown on substandard drugs, NDTV was able to easily purchase heparin and nitroglycerin injections. These are part of the 9 life-saving drugs recently banned due to quality concerns of the same manufacturer. The process was disturbingly straightforward. We approached the medicine shop inside Hamidia Hospital, requested the injections, made the purchase and received an official bill, all without any checks.
बिल रख दिया उसमें आपने ठीक
The 9 life-saving drugs that have been temporarily banned are primarily used in intensive care units in operation theatres.
कई जो दवाइयां हैं वो जीवन रक्षक दवाइयां हैं इसमें खास तौर पे जो हम आईसीयू में पेशेंट्स जो होते हैं जिनका ब्लड प्रेशर कम होता है जैसे इसमें एक नाम है डोपामिन तो वो ऐसी दवाई है कि जब पेशेंट का ब्लड प्रेशर कम होता है तो उसको बढ़ाने के लिए काम में आता है इसके अलावा अगर पेशेंट जब कार्डियक अरेस्ट में चले जाता है तो उसका जब CPR करते हैं तो वो CPR करने के दौरान ये काम में आने वाली दवाई जैसे नॉरएड्रेनालिन है तो इस तरह से ये जो दवाइयाँ हैं ये इमरजेंसी सेटअप में जीवन रक्षक दवाइयाँ हैं और इनकी जो गुणवत्ता है ये सर्वश्रेष्ठ होना चाहिए अगर उसमें कुछ भी कमतर है तो ये बड़ी मतलब कि विपरीत परिणाम देने वाली स्थिति बन सकती है
The real problem lies in the fact that no one knows how long this compromise in quality has been happening.
हमने रैंडमली जो है जांचें करवाई है, तो ये बैच की जो है वो रिपोर्ट अच्छी नहीं आई है, तो रैंडमली भेजा है, जो सामने दिख रहे थे वो भेज दिया।
While the health corporation is responsible for supplying medicines, 90% of these medicines are often unavailable in hospital stocks. As a result, patients' relatives are forced to buy medicines from shops located within the hospital premises. The concerning part is that these medicines are readily available in those shops. This raises serious questions about the effectiveness and integrity of the supply process, essentially rendering the entire system meaningless. The real question remains how long this compromised quality has persisted, with more than 90% hospitals in the state facing a shortage of essential medicines and the quality of supplied drugs in question. The situation is alarming. The state government must act swiftly to restore public trust and ensure that such lapses do not occur again. In Bhopal, with camera person Rizwan Khan, Anurag Dwari for NDTV.
So absolutely shocking there. But looking now at the big international headline, well, the UAE has managed to broker the latest captives exchange deal between Russia and Ukraine. And the latest coming in, well, over 200, in fact, 230 to be precise, captives have been released in this latest captives exchange deal. So, of course, this is the seventh exchange deal broken by the UAE. And well, with that, it's a wrap on the show. Thanks so much for watching. Goodbye.